Okay, I guess we're good to go. Shall we start? Okay. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to part one of PEC ACM CSS's Getting Started with Competitive Hackathons on Project Development. Before we dive in, some of you must have an idea about what a hackathon is, and we'd love it if you can tell everyone what you think a hackathon is. You may unmute yourself or put it down in the chat box. Anyone can come and unmute and let us know what they think a hackathon is. And if you've taken part in one, you can talk to us about that experience as well. Manjot says, coding event in which projects are made in a limited amount of time. Pretty much bang on, right? There are a few variations of this particular definition, but let's dive into it. So the first question is, what exactly is a hackathon? Gunit, if you can go to the next slide. So a hackathon is a weekend-long event where people come together to find and implement solutions to given problem statements. In a nutshell, well, basically you can find variations of this description online, such as it's a coding event or it's an event in which coders come together to code things, but that's not true. A hackathon is attended by people from all kinds of walks of life, ranging from designers, entrepreneurs, hardware enthusiasts, and most commonly programmers. The word hackathon is a combination of two words. The first one being hack, which means to find solutions to challenging problems in a novel and clever way. And the second being marathon, which is a long period of time dedicated to one particular objective. Next slide, please. So let's talk very briefly about how a hackathon works. There are a lot of different types of hackathons, but a few guidelines remain constant throughout. Participants make a team of generally 3 to 5 team members who work together to find solutions to problem statements which are given to them, and they do so within a span of usually 48 hours. There are hackathons which are spread over 24 hours only, or some which are 72 hours, but usually it's a weekend-long thing. The first step is to form your team. You can either form it prior to the event or find teammates during it. The second step is to choose a problem statement. Keep the problem statement in mind at all times and start throwing around ideas to start finding solutions that you can implement. From my experience, devising checkpoints for your 48 hours is very helpful if you want to stay on track. The third step is to start building and converting your idea to a prototype. Make sure to keep your communication steady throughout the 48 hours to avoid any critical failures and especially, of course, miscommunication. The next step is sessions with mentors. In hackathons, generally there is a subject matter expert who is sometimes also like an industry professional, which is assigned to one or more teams, and their job throughout the whole process is to assist you with everything that you need. If you need knowledge or resources, then the mentor is the first person that you should consult. The fifth step is the final pitch. You worked very hard in the last 40-ish hours. You're probably sleep deprived, probably hungry as well, and have consumed an unacceptable amount of coffee. But it all boils down to this. You will be evaluated on multiple factors, such as the quality of your prototype itself, the authenticity and innovation of your idea, and the amount of progress you were able to make. And finally, after the judges have observed all the projects, the winners are announced. Staying up for 48 hours working on a single goal can be a grueling experience. So then the obvious question that arises is, why should you take part in a hackathon in the first place? Is it because of the money that you win as the cash prize, or because it'll look good in your CV or resume when you are applying for internships and jobs? Or is it the refreshments that you get during the 48 hours? The simple answer is all of the above and some more. So here are three very famous annual hackathons. Imagine Cup, which is organized by Microsoft. The winner gets $100,000 cash prize. Flipkart Grid, INR 1.5 lakhs to the winner. And the HackerRank, hackathon, which is also annual and organized in association with Vere, which pays you 40,000 US dollars if you win. Cash prizes are not the only thing to be gained. There's a lot more. For example, many companies offer you the chance to put your idea into the real world and fund your team and project so you can implement your idea and put it to use in real life. If you really believe in your idea, this is an excellent chance to materialize your vision for it in the real world. Apart from hefty cash prizes, Flipkart also offers its winners an opportunity to intern with them. And not just them, but the top 50 teams all over India get this opportunity. A lot of companies also extend you a job offer if you do well in their hackathons or one of these hackathons. During the event, you get to meet a lot of people ranging from other participants who have great ideas and experiences to industry professionals who are present as subject matter experts. And so you get a chance to network with them. Hackathons are not and should not be just about the things you build, but more about the ideas you share and the knowledge you accumulate throughout. In my experience, hackathons are a great catalyst when you want to start learning something new. Taking things step by step is usually a great idea, but more often than not, an environment which induces urgency is exactly what you need. Participants running around day and night to figure out solutions to problems, teams sitting and figuring out the exact right pitch to sway the judges in their favor, and the rush of building something new to wow the world. It all induces a sense of urgency within you, and your mind adapts to taking in new information at a much faster rate. Now, I understand that making things is hard. Making good things is harder still, but making something good in 48 hours can seem impossible. So here's Guneet to tell you what your first step should be.
So now that we have talked about what hackathons are, let's talk about from where you can get started. The first step on this journey that we would suggest is to explore development. Now the question is, why should you go for development? Well, first of all, it is one of the most flexible and creative fields in computer science. If you enjoy being creative, then this is something that will definitely keep you happy and inspired. You can create pretty much anything that you can imagine. And one thing that's really cool is that once you get into development, very soon you will find yourself using your own creations. There is no limit to how creative you can get over here. Then another advantage of development is that you can explore other technologies along with it. It's a very versatile field. If you are interested in augmented reality, virtual reality, machine learning, or cybersecurity, then you can always combine these interests of yours with development to create some amazing projects. And if all those factors don't inspire you already, then there will always be a demand for developers in the tech industry. And software companies are always looking for developers. Now, next, I'd like to talk about some of the myths surrounding development. The technology is the most important and challenging part. Well, that's not really true. Before developing a website or an app, you need to understand what your users are looking for. And you need to trace an overlap between those needs and what technology might facilitate. So before starting a project, ask yourself what problem you're trying to solve. Once you have figured out what the problem is, then you try to understand what would motivate someone to download your app and how you can ensure that what you build is something that people will be interested in using. Once you have figured out all these factors, the technology aspect of development is going to be easier for you. And trust me, it's really not that difficult to learn how to develop something once you have in mind what you want to make. I need to be proficient in a suitable framework or language before starting development. So like I said earlier, first think about what you want to create regardless of your current skills. After that, select the languages or framework that best meet your needs. And then after learning just some basics, you can start developing and continue mastering the art alongside development. So you don't need to have all these skills on your fingertips before starting. The more the features, the better. Now think of the benefits your website or app is providing instead of the number of features. And you must focus on perfecting those essential features first. and don't load your product with unnecessary or redundant features. And this will only reduce the appeal of the product. And in some cases, it might also lead to memory hogs and functional issues. And large number of features does not automatically mean that your product is good. Once a website or app is built, your work is done. So your work definitely does not end there. Once you are done with development, it is important to extensively test your website or app, and you will definitely find many bugs that were not so obvious to you during development. Before you put your product out there for others to use, you must also work on scaling it so that it can efficiently handle more number of users. And you can also consider securing your application against cyber attacks. And still, the journey doesn't end there. Regular maintenance and bug fixes will ensure that you continuously improve your own skills as well as the quality of your product. Now we know that it is difficult to get started on this journey, but we want you to know that you don't have to be an expert or have years of experience to make something useful or to make something that has a real impact. So to inspire you and to give you an idea of the kind of amazing projects that you can create, we now have Ajay and Aseem, who will show you their app and web projects.
Ajay, you are muted.
All right, not the first time that has happened, but okay. So as Guneet said, you don't really need to know a framework completely before you want to build an application or a website with that. I'm just gonna go ahead and show or tell a short story of one of my projects that I built in my third semester. Hopefully it won't bore you, it actually motivate you. So is it visible, the presentation?
Yeah, I think you're good to go.
All right, so the project name or the product name, or as I like to tell everyone when I'm talking about Pamphlet, that is not just any project or a product that I made. Pamphlet is actually that part of my life that changed my entire career. From where I started to where I am today, it's all because of Pamphlet. I'll go ahead and tell you how that is. So first of all, the application name is Pamphlet, Buy, Sell, Earn. And a little introduction. So Pamphlet is basically a mobile application, a cross-platform mobile application. In which suppose you want to sell one of your items that you're no longer using. Suppose you're in your third semester, you're moving into your fourth semester, you no longer need your third semester books or notes that you created or anything else. You can basically create an ad out of that and upload it on Pamphlet, and your juniors who are moving into third semester and want to buy that book or something else that you're selling can tell you that they are interested in the product that you're selling and they want to meet and exchange money for your product. So basically on the surface, it looks kind of like a very basic OLX or Quikr kind of app, but it actually has a really interesting story behind it. Now this presentation is what I basically created to pitch in front of the college authorities to get the seed funding. So it basically had a lot of story that actually did not happen. For example, whatever written in this context, you can go ahead and actually read it, but it's not 100% sure. Because this is something you write to get money out of your investors. So I'll tell you the exact story behind Pamphlet. So if you want to read it, you can. But the actual story of Pamphlet began when I entered college. So when I entered college, I was actually kind of shy and introverted and could not talk to my seniors or even my batchmates. So what happened was that I was at a huge disadvantage because all my batchmates and classmates were going to the seniors asking for advice, asking for the secondhand books at cheaper cost. And there are a lot of things, for example, a lab coat that you actually need only once a week and you don't actually have to buy it to get through the semester. You can actually just buy it once, or you know, you can take it secondhand or just borrow it for one lecture every week and you're good to go. You don't actually have to buy a new lab coat. So all of my classmates were going to the seniors, asking for books, asking for notes, tips, advices, borrowing lab coats and all that stuff. And while I was shy and introverted, I could not actually go to my seniors to ask for these stuff. So I was actually at a very big disadvantage when I joined college. And I knew I have to do something about it because I was facing this issue right from the first semester of my college. So I knew I have to solve it because there were several more semesters to go. And so what I actually decided to was create an application for Punjab Engineering College where people, the seniors, could just go ahead and post what they don't need anymore, like lab coats or their books that they are not using anymore, or the notes that they created for the subjects in their previous semester or anything like that. And anyone with least personal interaction can go ahead and purchase or borrow those things. So this is how Pamphlet actually came into being. And this was kind of an escape plan that I created for my own personal issues, the shyness and the introvertedness. But it actually ended up as, you know, plan that eventually helped me overcome all of those stuff. Because when I released Pamphlet, the night I released Pamphlet, I told like a couple of friends of mine over WhatsApp that I've created the application, and I went to sleep. And the next morning when I actually woke up, there were so many texts from unknown numbers, and they were all of my seniors and batchmates and classmates who had texted me congratulating me for the amazing application that I had built. And I did not really believe that it would reach that many people, but overnight we had around 150 plus downloads on the application, and my WhatsApp was full of messages, congratulations and appreciation and all that stuff from all unknown numbers, and I did not know who they even were. So I went ahead and just replied thank you and all that to everyone, and eventually I found seniors and batchmates and classmates who were actually very, very supportive and who gave suggestions how I could improve Pamphlet, what new features I could include. And that way, a single small step each day, I eventually got over my shyness, my introvertedness, and the fear of talking to seniors or my juniors or my batchmates. And eventually, the Pamphlet I created as an escape plan actually turned out to be a plan that helped me get over my issues. And this was the first project that I built all by myself. That eventually got me into coding especially. And as I moved forward into the coding domain, I actually then went into open source, and maybe you, some of you know that I actually got into Google Summer of Code as well. And all of that started from Pamphlet itself. So had I not created Pamphlet, had it not gotten viral into in our college overnight, and had I not talked to my seniors about it, I probably would never have applied into Google Summer of Code and probably would never have been here in this call itself. So Pamphlet is the software that helped me get over my fears, that actually helped me reach where I am today. So just a motivational story that mobile development or web development or all these kind of stuff are not just to create a project to put in your CV so that later on you could get an internship and later on a job. But it actually teaches you a lot, not just the technical stuff, but also a lot of life skills, the soft skills that you need to put in your life to move forward. Because these technical skills are not the only thing that you need to excel in your career. There are a lot of other things that you'll learn over time if you go on and try to find solutions for the problems that you fail in your, that you face in your daily life. And eventually, as you start thinking of solutions, start converting your solutions into actual prototypes, you realize how much there is to learn beyond just frameworks or coding or anything like that. And also, one thing I'd definitely like to point out is that I did not actually know Flutter in depth when I started thinking of a solution like Pamphlet, and I actually learned it on the go. So you really don't have to know in depth of any framework or anything like that to start your coding journey. So just look around yourself, the problems that you face in your daily life, the problems that your friends are facing in your daily life. Think of a solution, how that can be solved either by a mobile application or by a website. Create, if you know about it, then create a design document. You can Google what a design document is. Create your wireframes, your solutions, write them down, talk to your friends, create a team, and have meetings, discuss how many more features you can add, what designs you can improve and all that stuff. It's actually very, very fun when you do it with a team. So gather a few people, start thinking of solution, have meetings, just like how it works in an industry or in a startup, and you'll find out how much more fun it is than it actually seems. So don't just do it to put projects in your resume, actually do it to solve some real life problems or things that you face around yourself or your friends face, and you will eventually fall in love with this whole software development process. So this is one of the favorite things that I always tell to people whenever they ask me about Pamflet, how I came to the icon idea. So I'll just go back and show. This is the two Fs representing Pamflet is the icon of the application. And the way I reached it is Pamflet actually comes from the English word pamphlet, which is actually an ad flyer, a typical paper flyer where you put in an ad or something. So if you imagine a pamphlet in this shape, the image on the right, you can actually see the top right corner actually resembles two Fs from where pamphlet emerges. So this is just the basic of how pamphlet looks. If you want, you can actually download it from Play Store. It's not on the App Store that is for iOS, but it's actually on Play Store for Android devices. And you can go ahead and search Pamflet and download it to see how it actually works. But this is just how the basic design looks. You can search for academic products, unacademic products and services. And you can look at the prices, who is selling, what the product is, the description of the product. You can also go ahead and add your own products that you want to sell. Apart from that, one of the most important features of Pamflet is the bargaining one, because we all know we are all teenagers and students. We cannot bargain actually face to face. So this is one of the most important features that separates Pamflet from all the other similar products. It is that when you're placing a request, you're telling your senior or your batchman that you're interested in one of your products. Let's say if someone is selling a secondhand book at 200, you can actually mention that you want it at 160 or 180. Without much personal interaction or physical interaction. You can just simply tell that you want it for 160 or anything lesser than that. And that will send a request to the seller, and then they can either accept or decline virtually. So you can actually do it without any physical interaction. And apart from that, security was one of the main issues of the application. So if you are a seller, you're selling something, your phone number will not be shown until you accept someone's offer. So basically, the only person who will get your number is the person whom you have agreed to sell your product. Apart from that, no one else can get your number. So one of the biggest security issues solved like this. And all of these solutions are reached at by talking to your teammates, by brainstorming ideas, various solutions you can put forward, how you can make your application even more secure. And this is actually how things work. Like if you are in a team, you put forward your idea, someone tries to improve the idea that you put forth, and someone brings in a completely new idea, then you try to improve their idea. And this is how it goes back and forth. And so the complete solution looks something like this. For now, the first two features have been implemented in the sell and buy features in Pamflet 1.0. The services and discussion features is yet to be implemented in Pamflet 2.0, which will be released soon. So this is the complete solution, how it looks, what we are trying to create using Pamflet. So basically, whatever you don't want, you can sell that. You can actually pinpoint which senior is selling what you need, and you can just a single platform where you can find your seniors, what they're selling, and buy them. Apart from that, the services and the discussion features yet to be implemented. But service is basically, let's say, if you are good at creating Excel sheets or presentations, or if you're good at creating apps, so you can actually sell your service as well at some cost, like $50 per hour or something like that. Like I can make one presentation for $200 or something like that. And discussion is basically a thread where you can ask your seniors for advice, and people can comment and create threads like that. This is simply like Reddit, how Reddit works. So this is the whole complete solution of Pamflet. And apart from just being a mobile application coded, it is actually a whole product that helped me evolve from a person who was really shy and introverted to a person who can now go on to any workshop and talk whatever he feels like. So it's not just your coding journey that starts when you start creating the solutions for your problems. It's a whole development process. You don't just develop technically, you develop personally as well. So this was the whole story of how Pamflet came into being, and how Pamflet is doing right now. And we are still improving it. We are still working on it. We brainstorm ideas almost every day. We come up with new solutions, how Pamflet can be improved, new designs. And it's an amazing environment. You can actually talk whatever you want, and helps to, you know, helps in basically open you up so that you can put forward your ideas, no matter how crazy they might sound at first. And, you know, basically helps you improve as a whole person, makes you an asset to the team, whichever you're going to join in the future. So this was the whole story of the pamphlet. Hope you liked it. And if you have any questions, do go on and ask them. If you want to join the team of pamphlet, do tell me, do PM me, or just say, writing in the chat here. We'll love to, you know, hear your ideas about it. And I hope you too will find solutions for problems around you, faced by you or your friends, and eventually come up with amazing ideas like this. And yeah, that's it. Thank you very much.
We'll open up to questions in a few minutes after the whole thing's over. Aseem, I think you can share your screen now.
Yeah, I guess Anuj has asked, can we make it available for the colleges as well? Yeah, this is actually, this has been coded actually. It's not about to be implemented. It has already been implemented in Pamphlet 2.0. But I'm actually not releasing it right now because Pamphlet is basically meet and exchange the product you're selling with money. And since it's locked down, not everyone is in college, so you cannot actually use it right now. So I'm waiting for the time when college goes offline so that I can release Pamphlet 2.0. But this has already been implemented in 2.0.
Ajay, let's just wait for questions, no?
Yeah, sure.
Aseem, you can go ahead.
Yes. Thank you, Ajay. This was a wonderful presentation. So after you all have seen a really great app product, let me show you about a website that we have created. This was a team project that me and my team created in my second year. It is called Compraventa. So let's firstly discuss about the problem statement that we discussed and created the solution for this. It is about digital cryptocurrencies. Like, we all are aware that cryptocurrencies are now one of the most hot topics. People are earning ton of money. But when we think of ourselves, that if I want to invest in cryptocurrency, there is a fear that if I will lose, there is no coming back. So we want to solve this problem by creating a platform where we will provide the exact prototype of how the professional cryptocurrency websites work. And here you can actually do everything that you are doing in a professional cryptocurrency website, but you don't have to spend your money because we are giving you a play money. You can use our money, our play money, and do transactions, selling, prediction system, chart analysis. And by that, it is an aim for us that you will learn eventually how to trade in cryptocurrency. So first of all, let me tell you why we chose this project. This was not the first idea that we were going to implement. Our first main idea was to do something which is really effective, which can affect on our environment, and which is not just a simple project. So first of all, we were trying to make a stock market simulator type of thing. So when we start diving into that, we thought that if we are going into finance thing, why don't we just explore the cryptocurrency world? This was a 4-member team project. We all were curious about how cryptocurrencies are working. I personally don't have so much knowledge about cryptocurrency before starting the project, but I always want to explore this world. I always want to see that how the transactions happen, what is the technology behind this. And we thought that by making this project, it will really help us to understand the background of cryptocurrency trading. So we move on to this project. So Compraventa is the solution, which basically means buying and selling in Spanish. What I have learned in this project, this is the project that helped me to learn how to collaborate in a team. This was a team project, and fortunately I got a great team, and it helped me to how we are planning in a team, how we are scheduling our meetings, how we are creating deadlines for a particular work, and really help us to make this project in 2 months, which was really great. So there are some of the features that we are providing in the website. I will just give you a demo and show you the features. This is the UI of my website, Compraventa. We deployed the website on Heroku platform. So after signing in, this is the dashboard of our website. It is like the main essence of Compraventa, where you will be analyzing the whole information of the prices of any cryptocurrency. You will be analyzing the graphs. You will be using prediction system. You will be analyzing the news, and eventually you will be doing transaction. So I will not go into deep details about cryptocurrency, but I will show you some of the features. Like here you can select the cryptocurrency coin pairs. Here you can see the charts. You can also select the chart according to the intervals. So as you can see that we are showing the prices data from 2018, almost 3 to 4 years, which really helps a trader to analyze that how the market prices are reacting to any cryptocurrency, how the prices are changing, how they are changing from any interval, whether they are changing from a week or month or any single second. Cryptocurrency prices are changing every second, and it's really have a long transaction. When we started the project, the price of Bitcoin was around $56,000. It also reached to $60,000 as well. And by the time when we ended our website, it also reached to $39,000 as well. So it is about that there is no thing that surety in this world, but one trader can always analyze the whole thing and gain profit. We came here with the new section by seeing that how a tweet by a person can change the market trend, how companies are reacting to cryptocurrencies, how different policies of different banks, different policies of different countries are changing the cryptocurrency prices. For that, we came up with a new section, which is tagged by the cryptocurrency. For the prediction system, we use some simple moving averages, which is really effective in predicting the prices. By here, you can select the interval and predict your price and analyze by that. So red means that price will fall down. So according to that, we can do transaction. And let me tell you that this was not the first thing that we planned about this website. We were not sure in the that how many features we will add, how many things we will add. We just start by thinking that we will do buying and selling. But eventually, when we thought that if a person is going to buy something, if a person is want to sell a cryptocurrency coin, he will firstly want to analyze the information of any coin. For that, we have to provide every information that is needed for doing any transaction. So that here we have provided every information that is sufficient to analyze the trend of any cryptocurrency price. Here is a transaction point section where you can actually do the transactions. There are two types of transactions, the market and stop. The market transaction is done at the actual price of that particular coin. So for example, if I want to buy a Bitcoin, if I want to buy a 0.005 Bitcoin, it will be bought at this price that is changing every second, and the transaction will happen. But the really amazing feature of our website that we have brought is the stop feature. Here you can actually decide at what price you want to sell your coin, at what price you want to buy your coin. So this helps the traders to set a value where they want to sell and or buy any coin. For example, we just have saw that according to our prediction, after 3 days, the price will drop. So we can pick a lower price and we can buy our coin at that time. When the price will hit at that time, our transaction will be done automatically, and an email will be sent to the user's account for when the transactions happen. So for example, if I want to buy a Bitcoin at 42,000 Tether, then it means that when the price of the Bitcoin will reach at 42,000 Tether, the transaction will be happen automatically. So here you can see that I have initiated a stop loss feature, and you can see all of these transactions, all of these, the account section you are happening in my profile section. So here you are seeing that today at this time, I have started a stop feature at this price on this amount will be bought. Since this is a learning, this website that we have built is for learning purpose, we have added here reset account feature. This was a really great feature that we thought at the coming end of our website. Like, we didn't thought that there is need of such kind of feature when we started making this project. But when we thought that ourselves, we were playing with this website, we were ourselves practicing trading, we were suffering some losses because we were not trained traders. So we were thinking that when a person is having some loss, and after loss and loss, they want to do a fresh start. They want to think that I have learned something from my mistakes and I want to do a fresh start. So by a reset account detail feature, you can reset your all account details and you will be automatic, or all your transactions will automatically be erased and you can do a fresh start. This really helps a student to actually learn how the trading works, that you are learning from your mistakes, you are resetting your account, and after that you will be hoping that next time you will be gaining some profit. We also want that the user should be motivated each time. So for that, we created a rating and asset earn system, which gives you a rough idea about how much profit you are earning and what is your rating system, because everyone wants to earn more and more stars. So this was the website that we have created. The really great story about this is that it was the very first website that I have built where we are involving so much technology, and we were really not aware about that. We really started from the very first basics. The learning process was in the ongoing process of development. We learn, we develop. We ask our seniors if we are having any doubt. When we thought that our website is completed, we really took more than 10 to 15 days before submission of our website to actually find out the bugs. I literally sent every one of my senior, please check my website and tell me if you are finding any bug. This really helped me to improve my website. This tells my friends, my seniors, that we are creating something, and they really responded well. So by this, I want to just tell you that don't think that for creating something, a website like this, which really seems complicated, you don't have to be a really good developer. You just have to have a positive mindset, and you have to move on with that. You just start with your idea and have a clear idea. Just don't think that at the first day you will be having the clear idea of the whole website and you will not be adding any feature. You have to have a clear idea what you want to do, and by the time you are moving on, you can append your website every time. Because when you really implement your features, it is the time when you think personally that if I am using a website, if I am using this X person's website, how is the user experience going on? How the person is reacting? Is this really comfortable or is this too technical? When we thought that it might be too technical, we created a learn feature as well, where we provided all the material resources and other links where people can really study about these things and then go to trading system. So this was my website which I am really proud of. And by this, I only want to tell you that keep always think that what you can do for the society and collaborate with people. They are really amazing people in your college as well. Try asking them out about, do you have any idea or you want to work on any project. Don't think that other person will think of myself that why he want to add me. Just try to learn some things and build with that. So thank you.
Thank you, Asim and Ajay. Guys, if there is anything to learn from these projects, there are two things. First of all, you need not be a subject matter expert or have years and years of experience of a particular framework or development methodology. In fact, having participated in more than 7 hackathons and actually having won some of those, I can only tell you that it is the opposite. You get an idea, you believe in that idea, and you start making it, and the trajectory of the rate at which you are learning, along with what you are learning, it shoots up inevitably really, really high, right? And the second thing to remember is every great project starts with an idea, a great idea, an idea that the people who are making that project believe in. So for Asim, it was the fact that he wanted to learn about this ever-evolving technology, which is cryptocurrency. For Ajay, it was to overcome his shyness and introvertedness. Our aim as ACM is to see 100 more Asims with Compraventas and 100 more Ajays with their pamphlets, because we believe that you all have great ideas and we want to see them out in the world, working and serving people in general, so that, you know, You can materialize your vision. Taking the first step from going from a place where you have ideas, but you don't know how to implement them, to a place where you can actually see it making a difference in the world is hard. But keeping the second point in mind, which was that every project needs a great idea to start with, we have decided to hold an ideathon, which is only a little bit different from hackathon. It's a hackathon minus any coding or prototype building. You need to make teams of 3 to 5 people and come up with ideas by the 10th of October. On October 10th, midnight, we'll open up a 24-hour window in which you can submit your ideas. These ideas can be anything that you want to build, and you can submit it in the form of a PowerPoint presentation or a design document, whatever you feel like. There are no problem statements or themes, because for some of you, this might be the very first thing you build using technology, and we don't want to limit your freedom in any way. Teams whose ideas are selected will be assigned mentors, which will be us, your ACM seniors only, as we guide you through to every part of your journey. Greet, can you explain the next steps, please?
Yes. And so once you're allotted your mentors, then you can start the building process. So you'll have the time of around about a month, and you'll have continuous support from your mentors during that. Now, during this long 1 month span, you can easily learn the technologies that you need along the way. So you already have your brilliant idea with you. In that 1 month, you just need to focus on the implementation. You need to know, you need to figure out what technologies you want to learn. And you'll have these mentors who already have some experience in development. So you'll learn a lot from their experience as well. And once you are done converting your idea into the prototype, then there'll be the time for the final pitch. So in the final pitch, you will be presenting your idea and the implementation to a panel of judges. And you'll get to know the details about that when the time comes close. But basically, we'll be judging your idea, how good your idea is, how suitable it is, and also how well you have been able to implement it. Because of course, once you've thought of the idea, we do expect you to put in work in the implementation and come up with some kind of a prototype. It doesn't have to be perfect, but we want you to work hard towards that idea. And then after that, we'll be announcing the results. Now the top teams will be getting some kind of prizes, but even if you aren't one of those teams, remember that this journey is going to be a really fun journey, and you're going to learn so much from it, and you'll gain so much experience, which is going to help you throughout your time in college. And once you've gained experience from this, you'll be ready to participate in those competitive hackathons, which expect you to build things within a very limited time of 48 hours or 72 hours. And I would just like to repeat that we are not expecting you to be expert coders before you start participating in the ideathon. All we need is passion and dedication. These two things are very important. And if you are passionate and you are dedicated, then you can easily learn the coding aspect along the way. And with that, I'd like to open up the chat to any questions that you would have about the ideathon or about development in general. We're here to answer any kind of doubts you have.
Good evening, ma'am. Ma'am, I have a doubt ki matlab team formation kis basis pe honi chahiye, ki matlab kya hame mind mein point rakhne chahiye ki ye hamari aisi team honi chahiye.
So team formation mein like you shouldn't judge is basis par ki kise kya technology aati hai. At this point, I think you should see ki aapke team mein jo sab hai wo iske liye dedicated hai ya nahi. Because ye 1 month ka process hai, to usme you need ki aap 1 month pura dedicated raho us cheez ke liye. So I think you should just see if the people who are interested in participating with you, if you think ki they are also passionate about it, then you should just go for it.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Any other questions are welcome. You can put them in the chat box, or you can unmute your mic and speak. I think somebody asked, I think Chirag asked, should the teams be from the same college? Could it be the team be a mix of students from different colleges? I, at the moment, don't see any issues with letting anybody who wants to participate actually participate. If you have ideas and you want to build things and you want someone to mentor you, that is all that is necessary. Anyone can take part. Please repeat about the stages of ideas on. You need, I think you can take this one better.
So in the ideathon, first you make your team. It will have like 3 to 5 members in it. After that, till 10th of October, all we want you to do is come up with an idea. So with your team, you can brainstorm. You can think about, like, you know, you can think about what problems there are in the world which can be solved using technology. And then you find out which problem it is that you are passionate about. Or you can think about, like, you know, like Asim said, he wanted to learn about cryptocurrency. So that inspired him. If there's something like this that inspire you, you can build your idea upon that. So like this, along with your team, we are just giving you ample time to, first of all, just come up with an idea. Now, once you have come up with an idea, we'll tell you exactly how we want you to share the idea with us. Those details will be given. So you'll be sharing what you have come up with us. And then we will select teams from that. And those teams will be assigned mentors. Now, the mentors will be like students from amongst us only, like your third year, fourth year. And like all those people who are into development, they will be mentoring you. Now, the role of the mentors is that, like, you know, sometimes if you're confused about anything, they can guide you in that, and they can just keep a check on your progress and just make sure that you are building things on track, and any like technological issue you face, they can help you out with that. So they'll be there with you to guide you along the way. And so once this idea phase is over and you've been assigned a mentor, then you will start building your prototype. So the idea that you came up with, you will build something like a website or an app based on that idea. You'll have this time span of a month. Now, what exactly you want to include in that is completely your choice. Whatever features you feel are necessary, whatever you feel is important, you can include in that. And this prototype, like, you can take it to whatever level of perfection which you are able to. Like, even if you didn't make something that's absolutely perfect, it's totally fine. It doesn't have to be perfect. We just want to see your dedication and how you like try to overcome the technology challenges in it. And once you have built your prototype, then you'll have the final pitch. It will be like a presentation of the product that you have built. So you'll just give a demonstration of the product and like talk about the problem you're solving through it. And then you'll just have the result. I hope that was clear. Like, if you have any issue in any specific stage of the ideathon, then you can just let us know. Okay,
ma'am, can you brief about the prototypes, like what kind of prototypes you have to make?
Like you saw the projects that Ajay and Asim made. So like it does, of course, like they had a little bit more time, like they had the time of 2 months. So it had a lot of features. So don't be like scared after seeing something of that level. But so the prototype, it's basically you make a website or an app that is along the lines of your idea. So if your idea is that you want to like, so like, you know, Ajay explained his idea.
Like, it is a basic structure of a website which is having a small feature, and we are going on adding new features which are being discovered later. I think that's be the prototype. Yeah, like making the website regarding what problem we are solving, and we haven't included much feature, few of them.
Look, given the fact that we know ki you don't really know development, or most of you might not be proficient in it, we don't expect you to build a fully fledged website by the end of 30 days. A prototype is basically the core features are there, and you can show us the idea of them working, and whatever you build is fine. We don't expect you to build a completely functional website or an app, but we want you to get as close to it as you can, and that's one of the factors that we'll be judging you on.
Your main aim is just to should just be that what your idea represents and what your development represents in that idea. You don't have to think that you have to create really awesome thing. You firstly have to think that what your idea that you have pitched to us, that we have finalized and selected, that should be in your prototype.
Okay, sir. It's clear. Thank you, sir.
I hope we were able to clear that up. Any other questions?
And please don't think if you don't have any knowledge of development, then you should not participate. Whether you have any knowledge or you don't have any knowledge in any of the skills, you should participate, because it can be the starting point of your journey. You can start here from development.
Yeah, like Aseem said, knowledge or experience of coding really is not a factor here. That is why your mentors, or rather us, that's why we are here to assist you at every step of the journey. So you don't have to worry about that.
If Jaspreet is here, I guess we can stop recording now. Chat ko recording dekhe poochna
for a minute or more. Maybe somebody's typing, you know, you can't see them typing in the chat box. Just 60 seconds.
If anyone have any question, you can just speak up also. Don't have to.
Yeah, that's best. Any doubts? Don't worry about how you sound or you don't know stuff. Forget about all that. I guess not. So I hope we were able to clear up any doubts you had. And we hope to see a good amount of participation from your end in the ideathon.
Excuse me, sir.
Go on.
Sir, so by 10th, we just have to give you the idea.
Right. Just make sure to take your time till midnight, October 10th, to perfect your idea. The 24-hour window will open up. We guarantee you will hear about it, you know about it. And in that window, go and submit, and that's about it.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
You're welcome. Jaspreet, I think we can stop the recording.
All right.